This is Jamie O'Donnell with Search Engine Strategies in Chicago 2009. I'm with Topher Cohen from CNN, chief SEO for all of the new sites he manages, and he gave us some great suggestions on not so much getting your videos indexed by the search engines, right, as how to appropriately put the Christmas wrapping on them so they're going to get all the ranking you want and indexing you want and views you want. So, Topher, do you want to share those top three wonderful suggestions you gave the audience in the session just now?
Sure. So, in September, Google announced that they were going to start using Facebook Share and Yahoo Search Monkey, which is an RFDA microformat tagging thing. And so by using those, getting stuff indexed nowadays is relatively easy. Getting stuff into the index is relatively easy. What's hard...
All about sitemaps.
It's all about sitemaps, exactly. It's all about XML sitemaps or MRSS feeds. What's really hard is letting the engines know what to do with your content once they find it. I mean, the old joke is never leave anything up to the index. Do everything yourself.
Too many videos hitting the search engine drain at the same time.
Exactly. So what we really focused on, what I think everybody should focus on, is wrapping this in some sort of microformat tags and letting the indexes know. I believe that in the next 18 months or so, we're going to see some sort of standardized open source set of tags.
That's quick.
From Google and Yahoo.
That's pretty quick.
They actually started this when they announced the rich snippet, which uses microformats. Well, what Google did over the summer. So they've been working on this for a while, and Yahoo's had Search Monkey for years. So I think that that's really where we're going, and I made the bold statement inside that if you're an SEO and you're not paying attention to microformats and you're not looking at this stuff right now, then you're going to miss the boat.
It woke me up more than the Diet Coke I was drinking at that time.
I truly believe it's going to be the biggest game changer we've seen in a very long time. I really do. And I think that if you're not on board with it, then you're going to be waking up one morning with somebody asking you, why isn't my content showing up the way it used to?
Right. Then you talked about some interesting sharing of the videos on Facebook.
Yeah, the Facebook Share. Facebook Share is fantastic for one thing alone only, really, is the fact that it lets you know where your content goes once it leaves your site. And let's face it, anybody who's naive enough to think that your content isn't leaving your site and going somewhere else is just that naive. So the Facebook Share button gives an easy way for your users to share content on their Facebook page. But also, as the owner of that content, when you sign up to be a Facebook developer, you get a report, or you can access reports that show you where your video is being embedded, how many views it's getting, what the clickbacks are. And we've seen some really great traffic coming back from those videos.
From the embedding.
Yeah. And now, like I said inside, to be fair, we were having a hard time tracking that to start off with. So the numbers have increased, the numbers we've seen, I think, are relatively true. But going forward, we'll know more and more about that.
Right. And the third organization that you mentioned?
Microformats.org. They are the clearinghouse for these tags. It's no different than when you go to, like, Eventful or a concert website or something, and there's the add to your iCal or add to your Outlook or you go to somebody's website and download my information to your address book. That's using microformats, H-card, V-cards. That's really what their stuff started, is a way for people to use the content the way they want to. And so now we just take it into the search world to not only let the end user use the content the way they want, but give the engines clues of what that content is, what it means.
Mm-hmm. This is a topic you didn't speak out, and we can edit out if it's not an appropriate question. But one of the other speakers on the panel talked about tracking the top 100 users in the last 30 days, letting them know when they've got new content. At CNN, across all those properties, are you watching, who comes to your site directly, and the frequency, and who are your influencers within the whole sort of CNN audience community?
We do. We do that two ways. Yeah, we do that. You can sign up and have a profile.
Right.
And with the profile, you can set up alerts and such, right, as you know that. And you can do it through the iPhone app also and get notified when new subjects come up. But we, one of our sister sites is a site called iReport.com, so CNN mm-hmm. iReport, mm-hmm. and that's completely citizen journalism.
Right.
And so people signing up there, we really do track the people who give us a lot of content, mm-hmm. and we promote that content, whether it be on the iReport page or sometimes even on CNN.com's homepage.
So they flight themselves, they get themselves into the influencer and important list over time if they're contributing a lot to iReports.
Correct. Yeah, they do. And we have commenters, we have people that fill us, and We watch that, and we know who they are.
Right. Well, it was a great panel, and we look forward to most likely hearing more from you in New York in just a matter of months in your, you know, your hometown. And we'll be there in March, and we'll probably have some updates from you on how all these formats are coming along and other great insights.
Fantastic. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Ty.
Thank you.
Okay.